Welcome, my name is Bart Kempers and today we're very fortunate to take this C-Ray Sundancer 290 pre-production model out on the Westeinder Lake. A beautiful day today, and what I'd particularly like to start with is the walkthrough on the port side here, because this is quite a new concept. C-Ray introduced the C-Ray Sundancer 320 2017 in January with this particular concept, with this recessed bow, which I'll show you in a moment. And now we have the little sister between brackets, the C-Ray Sundancer 290. Everybody knows that the typical sport cruiser usually has a walkthrough here right in the middle, going up to the bow right through the windshield, which is not always very comfortable. It doesn't give you a safe feeling walking here, not having really good things to grab onto in rougher conditions. But what I particularly like is not only walking through the bow easily, but also that they've really used all the space by more or less joining the two sides, which were used on the previous cruisers, where you have this separation here and there's two inside areas with headroom. But now that you have these two combined, there's a really good use of the inner area, which I'll come back to later also. But again, going to the bow, it's just walking through, and notice that you're really well protected walking to the bow, and that this walkthrough not only gives you ease of going to the cleats for, well, mooring up, attaching fenders, etc., but it also adds to the safety, particularly for small children. And this area, as opposed to a traditional cruiser where you have more or less an elevated deck with sometimes cushions that are used as a sun pad, with this particular boat, with this recessed floor, you have a really good place to have these great lounging seats. And this is really a great place to sit. And of course, even though this is a pre-production model, this actually is number two. C-Ray is going to make number three, and only after number three they'll put the boat into production after, well, dealers and all technical stuff has gone through all these three pre-production models. But even though it is a pre-production model, ergonomics are already really good. As you can see, they've thought about armrests, the length is really good. And what I always like with C-Ray is all the attention to detail, such as this upholstery with the double stitching. And of course, stainless steel 316. The stitching here in a contrasting color I particularly like. And this particular boat is number two. And they filled it with, well, loads of extras. I don't know as a dealer yet which will be standard and which will be extras, but I'm sure there are quite a few extras on this boat, such as the extra remote for the stereo. I noticed there's two really big amplifiers below the steering position, below the helmsman seat. But there's an extra control here, there's one inside, there's one at the helm position, and there's also one in the aft. And there's a 12 volt receptacle here, and also two USB connections here. So while lounging here, you could easily charge your iPhone or iPad or other equipment. Speakers outside here, and as I said, a great place to sit here with two people. And if you fold these up, you can even have three people here on this area. Cup holders, a big railing, which of course adds to the safe feeling here. A non-skid area here on the bow, close to where the anchor is. The anchor being underneath this locker. Of course, the anchor is an option. This particular boat, there's a stainless steel anchor, which I personally always really like. But kept out of the way so that you can also use this as a step-on. And I haven't been informed yet whether this will be a standard, this split-up bow rail. I don't know, really, to be honest yet. But I really like this setup with this non-skid, so I can use it to go on and off the boat from the bow if you're mooring up at a higher mooring place. Cleats, of course, are always bolted through from the inside with the Sea Ray logo engraved. And even though this is self-baling, there's covers for this area. Of course, covers also available for the cockpit in different ways, so that you can either have a full cover just going straight or a full canvas camper package, so you can use the cockpit area as a nice social place also in different weather conditions. This particular boat has the full teak option, what I always like, because it really gives a very classy, very warm touch to a Sea Ray. Other options are of course the standard carpeting or the new Infinity flooring, which is also really nice, gives it a bit more modern touch. But again, this is full solid teak, which gives it this warm character. Of course, you can close this and the window, so that if you have different weather conditions, you're protected from the elements, especially being moored or being at an anchor with the wind coming from the bow, then you're sheltered from the wind here in this area. And well, this is a great cockpit, but as I said, I wanted to start with this walkthrough, which I really like and really is something new in the sports cruiser segment for Sea Ray, but also for other brands, of course. This particular area is really huge. You'll notice that there's plenty of seating. This is really long, and I lowered this backrest just to be able to show you that this can be used as a sunbed. Of course, this can be lifted up like this. Notice that this is quite high, which gives it this really comfortable feeling while on the way. If you are really making longer trips, what I always notice that there's plenty of boats which only have backrests coming up to here, and that well, doesn't help you feeling comfortable for longer periods. And the seat bases with Sea Rays are always quite long, slightly elevated here, which gives you a more secured feeling. And the new upholstery with this honeycomb structure here also gives it a more rich character. Notice that this particular cushion has hinges made out of stainless steel, so that you can access the extra portable cooler, and this, which can be used, of course, for storage or extra cooling space, I would say, really easily. Cup holders, of course, there's plenty of storage space below here. What I also like is that Sea Ray built in a double hinge here, so you can open it up, leave it open, standing upright, and putting things in and out with both hands. Grab rails, of course, on the right places, so that you can grab on in rough seagoing conditions. And you may have noticed, but there's LED lighting below here. I put it on, but of course it's quite a bit of light now out being outside on a beautiful day such as today, so you won't notice easily. But in during the night, this gives it a very warm and cozy character also. And you can have it probably in both blue LED lighting or in white, as on this particular pre-production boat number 2. A sink here, a double stove here. This works with alcohol, but I've seen on pre-production model number 1 that having one with an electric grill is also possible. You may want or need to install the generator if you choose that option. A nice stainless steel refrigerator here, with also a freezing compartment here, and the trash bin right here. So Sea Ray is really trying to use all the space there is on the boat for maximum storage. As I mentioned, this is number 2. Number 1 is already on the water. Number 2, this is number 2. Number 3 is coming also. And they will be testing all 3 boats and looking at all the spaces and going through all of them to maximize the use of storage, and also to have the input of several dealers and boating people to have a really efficient and nice thought through boat. Going to the helm, right here, this actually is also an option, having a, what they call at Sea Ray, a digital dash. And I put these screens on just to show you some of the capabilities. This is connected to the vessel view option that goes with a MacCruiser engine. And you can notice that you see all the gauges here in a digital way. And here you have a map, but of course you can swift or change between both options. You can also have a echo sounder, a display for the area below the boat. And there's even possibilities to link it with the new Fusion equipment, so that you can also control the audio from these two instruments, which are, by the way, built like this, flush, which gives it a really nice and clean look. There's the usual Sea Ray switches here, made out of stainless steel / chrome. If they're put on, they have this nice lighting. If you use the navigation lighting, there's always a soft glow to these switches, so that you can see in dark conditions which buttons you need. Again, new Fusion equipment, also made flush, installed in a way that it's, well, in the same depth, such as this. Really nice. The controls for the trim tabs. And, well, I'll come back to the rest later, but I really like this setup. Also with these steps here, if you use these thigh bolsters, which are meant to use a boat such as I'm doing now, but you can, of course, also put this down and sit here comfortably in this way. This double helmsman seat can be slid forward or aft, of course. So even for taller people like me, there's plenty of space. Non-skid here, by the way. An extra faucet here. I think that will be an option. And another thing which I'd like to point out is huge table. Made out of teak, that probably is going to be an option. But a huge table which folds back. This can be used as a grab rail. Plenty of space to sit there with a big group of friends. And of course, there's a shower at the transom, which can of course be used with warm water. As I mentioned, there's another control here for the stereo. And you have this submersible swim platform option here, which is really nice if you like swimming, bathing on this area here, or if people do wakeboarding, but because wakeboarders amongst us will recognize that it can be quite cumbersome to put the wakeboard on and off, and if you lower the swimming platform, the submersible swim platform, that makes it much more easy to put it on and off. And of course, there's also a four-step bathing ladder below. I'm not sure on which side, but there is one which also can be used to get in and out of the water easily. Okay, I'm not sure about this tower here. I think this is going to be an option, and of course the Bimini is probably going to be an option, but it will probably also be possible to have it without the tower, which can be interesting for areas such as the Netherlands, where we have many bridges. You have a lower height to go underneath bridges without having to wait for them opening, because this actually is quite low and it can be interesting, as I mentioned. And I'm pretty sure that in that particular case where you don't have the tower, there will still be an option for a Bimini and also a camper canvas package. Okay, let's go inside. Nice teak steps going down here, quite big, and a nice settee here. And again, I'm 1.93 meters. Plenty of space here to sit here comfortably. They installed a television here, a nice hardwood table, and of course also a nice hardwood floor. A really nice and cozy area. And what I particularly like is also the really huge portholes. On a day such as today, if the weather would change and you would have some rain, it is still really nice to be able to look outside. Nice and light atmosphere with these nice light ceilings and this all covered in this nice material. And of course this can all be used for storage. There's a small galley on that end with another refrigerator here. Small microwave, plenty of space to put to store things, telephones, iPads, whatever. Plenty of space, all is used, even below the floor here. And here we have the head. I'll go in so that the cameraman has the possibility to follow me. Plenty of space here also. This is all made out of fiberglass, so it can be easily be used as a shower. This can be taken out. Also some daylight here, medicine cabinet right above me. This nice glass sink. There's an electric toilet on this boat with the switches here. Grab rail even here, so you can grab on. This also gives you some extra daylight being in there with the door closed. So a really nice area with plenty of room. And here, of course, there's an extra place which can be used for lounging. We more or less made this in a way so that it can be used as a headrest or as a backrest, sitting here, reading a book, watching an iPad. But I always tend to show the length of the bed here, and I wasn't sure whether it was you were supposed to sleep like this or in this direction. This doesn't give me enough length, but this sure does. I have to be careful because of the audio being in my pocket. But if I go all the way, there's still place at my feet. So plenty of room here. Sorry, those are my keys. Plenty of room here with these nice thick mattresses. And even here, there's extra sockets. There's reading lamps to read a book during the evening. There's a small cupboard here. And also here, nice material. These are things that make Sea Ray separate themselves from other brands, because all the styling, wood, leather looking material, another material there, the combination is really nice and warm. But you don't tend to see a lot of fiberglass inside a Sea Ray, which just gives it a nice warm and rich look. Also here they used another kind of leatherish material, which is really nice. I really like the hardwood floor. Okay, let's go outside, and I'm going to start up the engine and take her out for a spin. Okay, there we are, back on the Westeinder Plassen, Westeinder Lake. Doing, let me quickly check. I will use this also. Engine. 1500 RPM approximately. The engine is still warm, 70 degrees. Oil pressure is really good. So, I'm doing 1800 RPM, and now we're actually going slightly too fast in this area, because we're supposed to do maximum 12 kilometers an hour. Now we're doing 13 and a half approximately. But still, going to a more open area. All the engine options, the standard engine option is a 6.2 liter Mercury V8, 300 horsepower, with the first option going up being the 350 horsepower engine option. But this particular boat has the V8, I think it's 4.2 liter diesel engine, which is really particularly interesting in specific areas where it's difficult to fuel up with gas. But I particularly like this because it also has a really good torque, this diesel engine. So putting her up to plane, well, it is quite a big heavy boat with one single engine, but still you'll notice that it this particular engine takes this boat up to plane in a really proper way. So 2000 RPM, let me take her up to plane. There we are. Kilometers an hour, taking down the speed slightly. Let me sit down for the audio and the wind. 40 kilometers an hour, doing 2900 RPM approximately. This actually is a really great cruising speed. It feels like there's still plenty of excess power and speed, which there is, obviously. Slightly over 3000 RPM, doing 38 kilometers an hour. Let me make some turns. Again, with the power assisted steering, makes it really easy. Just with one hand. Really, really easy. Let me go the other way. Feels really safe, secure, reliable. The engine is a bit more noisy than the gasoline option, but that is a choice you make when you choose for the diesel. I'm still surprised by how quiet it is, because I've had much more noisy engines in this caliber. It is 370 horsepower, quite a big, powerful engine. And let me take her up to top speed. There's no active trim this boat. I'll have to do the trimming myself. 55 kilometers an hour, 60, really high speed already for such a big boat, close to 9 meters, 65 kilometers an hour approximately is the top speed. She still feels very reliable, very safe. Fast turn, really fun to drive. It is a big sports cruiser, but it feels like a sports boat. Really great. And with that, I'm going to wrap up this review. I hope you enjoyed watching it. Thanks for joining me. Please remember that this is a pre-production model. There will be some at our facilities and probably at the next boat shows. So please be very welcome to visit us or other dealers. Again, thank you for watching. Hope to see you next time.